Well, good afternoon, everyone. This is the first music industry panel at A to D. What an illustrious lineup of people we've got for you. There's so much talent here, I'm surprised the stage is not groaning under the weight of them.
There's no right or wrong way to do it. I think we've kind of like, everybody has established their own way of doing things over the years. I think by working with as many people as possible, we can, locally is always the best place to start.
I think the main thing is gaining experience and working as often as possible, you know, every day, in fact, 7 days a week. You know. You have to kind of live it, I think, to really make a mark.
Some people think it's great that I'm not a musician. Sometimes I feel a little sort of inadequate that I can't sort of take the guitar off the guy and say, play it like this. On the other hand, I think it's an advantage because I'm more of a listener kind of thing. I mean, I have a lot of respect for musicians because they can do something that I can't do. You know, they can create magic and I still don't know how they do it, you know. So in a way, I feel I'm happy not being a musician, actually. I suppose I'm a better listener for not being a musician, but I'm not advising people to give up music.
One has to be a musician first, and a mathematician second, and a physicist, and there's a whole load of skills that you need to go into that. But the biggest skill of all is, of course, is experience and time. I think you've got to be multi-interests, yes, to be in the hardware business.
Part of the Featured Artists Coalition, you know, the reason for being there is to try and come up with ways that this music, you know, business can still continue into the future. And people don't have to be part-time, but they can dedicate their whole lives to making music if they wish to. So it's very, you know, so that's, I'd really like to encourage people to, you know, obviously get involved with the Musicians Union, and you can join the FAC as well, and then be involved in this debate and this discussion about how we're going to take this, you know, all you great young people out there with great new ideas, you know, should be part of this discussion, how we're going to take the music business forward, because it's different now. But music is so important to our culture, and it's so important that you have your voice.
You know, I can't really be derogatory about the internet, because it really is all things to all men. Yes, it's true, there are, you know, it is possible to make music to an appalling technical standard and get it out there and people will listen to it, maybe. But is that music going to be successful? It's much better if it's well recorded. It's better received. But then, you know, I could go off into another level here about quality and perception and how people like music. But it is better if it's well recorded. And eventually, people understand that.
20 years ago, a top-notch studio was £1,000–1,500 a day. That same studio is £400 a day. It's very difficult to run the shock of it all each year, you know, where studios go down, you know, they're just not there anymore. They're converted to flats, you know, all the major studios with the legendary records were made, you know, Olympic and Manor, you know, they've all gone. But at one time, you know, you're kind of spent 4 or 5 days doing a track or something, now you do back to the 60s, really. You're doing 3 songs a day, which is great. You know, it's great to have those limitations of doing things, but you just wonder if a lot of this music that is made for websites, for the internet, we're going to be listening to in 20 years' time.
For me, I totally embrace the internet. It is, you know, a reflection of the world. There's a lot of bad. And it's true, as the chap really said, a lot of the filters have gone, so there's certainly a lot of worse stuff coming through. But at the same time, I actually think it's now facilitating things which couldn't happen before, which ties into your question. Now, I'm personally living in South Devon. I'm working with artists literally all over the world. Now, that's not all done through the internet. I get on I kind of go there and I work with people. But a lot of those relationships have been fostered through the internet. And certainly a lot of the opportunities that I've had as an upcoming producer have come about through the internet, which if I was relying on the old system, which is clearly not there anymore, I would be struggling to make ends meet. You know.
We are in the age of the internet. We're in the age where we can know what's happened in Japan today and Libya and all that stuff. You know, we are totally connected. That's the world we live in. So let's embrace this new world and find a way to make it work, not be looking back to a different model of the business. We have to work out a way we can make a living for it, because being successful as a musician and an artist is making a living. It's not being a hobbyist, it's actually being able to put food on the table for your family. That's my definition. It's not actually selling millions of records, but it's actually, you know, can we make a living of this?
A lot of what we're trying to do in the new again, is to try and kind of educate, probably the wrong word, but just talk to people about, especially the younger people. They say, well, we don't care about downloading music for free because the record companies can afford it. Well, there's only four majors left, and there's still a good number of independents left, but if there's no record companies, then there's no signing a band, there's no paying the producers, and the whole thing kind of comes tumbling down. But what they don't understand is that it's kind of taken money away from musicians.
Whatever you're best at, find out what you really feel in your heart with music, and what you feel that you can really perform and, you know, your audience gets off on, and that's the direction you should go in. Really, I wouldn't go by fashion or, you know, ask people what they think new people are going to be listening to in a year's or 5 years' time. You know, do your thing, you know, do what you're really good at and enjoy it, you know, and then your audience feed off of that, and the audience will respect you and love you for that, you know. The engineer is, I guess, going to own the equipment or the studio and things, you know. It's funny enough, I mean, you can make great records on your laptop, you know, with the right mics and the right knowledge and with the right band and music, you know, you can make great records on your laptop. That's what we've got to now. There'll always be a need for studios. There'll always be, the biggest thing, I think, is even if you make the record on your laptop, you need a space to record it. And that space often reflects, the music reflects that space as well, I'll say, because If you have musicians in a great space, an acoustic environment, and the musicians are happy or unhappy on the music you're making, it's going to come across. So there'll always be a need for a space. And what the studios actually provide is expertise, really, of professionalism.
If you've got the training and the expertise to do good engineering, and production is, I mean, from a musician, producers have kind of bailed out so many records that I've been on, you know, they've ruined a few as well, but I won't go into them. But it's kind of managing the whole kind of the band situation as well. So by building up a good area of expertise, just like being a musician, and saying, yeah, I'll go and play anywhere I can just to kind of get experience, is by building up a nice little catalogue, a good CV, getting some clips up on SoundCloud or something. And you can really build up a profile that way. You don't have to go through the old methods of trying to get a producer, manager. You know, all these things are a bit more difficult than they used to. So there are other ways of doing it.
I think as we move more and more and more into the homemade technical laptop world, I think there's even more space for good quality engineers, because that's what sets you apart from everyone else for the laptop and software. Anybody can record, but only those that actually apply their lives to it can actually do it well and actually achieve those professional results, even on a low budget. So I think there's plenty of hope, but the guys are right. You have to kind of go out there and just annoy people and build up a CV. And then eventually people start to come to you, and that's great when that happens.
There's one very important fact that we all have to remember, particularly as engineers, in recording studios, and that is that it is very much easier to record a good musician than a bad musician.
I mean, I'm very much a believer in, really, we just have to create our own opportunities ourselves.
We really have to. We cannot sit at home waiting for some producer or in some office in London to say, I let you in. I let you in to this party. Don't, please don't be like that. It's only going to be your determination and your refusal to give up and to keep going. I mean, all artists who made it have had that attitude. They've got, I don't care what that person says about it. I don't care if they don't like what I do. I know this work is worthy of being heard. And you just keep going like that, and you keep listening, you keep adapting, and before you know it, you're actually doing what you want to do. But you started off doing what you want to do.
It's really all about kind of, at the outset, identifying who's putting what into the collaboration. And then at any point in the future, should any kind of income arise from it, that you know exactly who's entitled to what and how you're going to get that money from Spit and where from.
That's what we're dealing with here. We're dealing with protecting people being able to make a living, but also, you know, if copyright is absolutely held, you know, as a very, very strict thing, then all these amazing collaborations won't be able to occur. And it's one of the things that we all need to be talking about. You know, how are we going to do that?
Yeah, this is the biggest problem, isn't it? The internet is throwing up so many new things, it's keeping up. I just remains for me to thank all these people for travelling from all over the place. Many, many thanks. It's been